Okay, now we will see the guidelines for the preparation of model project report guidelines. Okay, what is that guidelines? So what are the information to be collected? Okay, formulation of the project report. First is general information. It has total eight phases. In that, first one is general information. In that, what actually you are going to do? Personal details of the stakeholders, such as name, address, qualification, experience and other capacity of the your entrepreneur. Okay, so partners, if partners are there, then the details also taken. So in general information, first details about the stakeholder. Stakeholder means the name and address, qualification of the person who is going to start the business, industry profile, analysis of industry to which project belongs. Okay, construction and organization, the construction and organization structure of your enterprise. Partnership means who is going to be the major partner, minor partner, like that. Certificate of registration, so those details have to be present. Product details means what? Product utility, product range, their design, their advantage, etc. have to be considered. Project description. Okay, what is that? Site, where location of the unit, owned, rented, leasehold, means whether that your site is owned or rented, whether it is an industrial area, whether any objection is there. Okay, if it is a residential, then you need to take NOC, no objection certificate. Raw material, requirement of raw material, whether inland or imported sources, okay, etc. to be collected. Skilled labor, availability of the skilled labor in the area, arrangement for training them, etc. data should be collected. Okay, these are the guidelines we are discussing. What guidelines for the preparation of the project report? Okay, next point you need to consider is pollution control. So whether you are dumping your waste, sewage system, treatment plant, infiltration, those should be mentioned. Communication and transportation, how you are going to communicate, how you are going to transport your goods. Okay, production process, this should be made for a process involved in production, involved in the production. Machinery and equipment, a complete list of machines and equipments required, indicating their size, their type, their cost and their sources, etc. should be mentioned. So all these data for machinery and equipment to be included. Okay, capacity of the plant, the installed or licensed capacity of the plant among with the shift should also be mentioned. Okay, technology selected, the selection of the technology, what type of technology you are selected for your production, arrangements made for it, acquiring, whether you are licensing, whether you are purchasing. Okay, all those details should be collected. Other common facility, what are those? Machine shop, welding shop, electrical shop. Okay, also should be mentioned in the project report. Research and development, a mention should be made in your report. A detailed topic should be made in your report regarding your R&D activities, regarding research and development activities. Okay, market potential, what is that? Demand and supply position, how much demand will be there, how much you are able to supply that one. So all those things should be included. Expected price, what type of price you are going to put. Marketing strategy, how you are going to sell your product. Okay, so those things have to be mentioned. Capital cost and sources of finance, where you are arranging, how much fund is required, owner's fund and funds raised from the finance or banks. These have to be mentioned in the report. Assessment of working capital, how much money you require for the normal working period. Okay, economical and social variables, every enterprise has its social responsibility. How your product, how your service is affecting economical society or sorry, economical nature or a society. Okay, those things have to be included. Project implementation. Okay, a detailed timetable for the project implementation. How much time is required to complete the activities for implementing the project, that has to be mentioned. Now we will go to the next concept, such as international entrepreneurship. International, you are from India. If you are doing a project or business in outside of India, then you will be called as international entrepreneur. Then your business is called as international entrepreneurship. Okay, it is the process of an entrepreneur conducting his business activity across the national boundaries. If you are going outside the nation, then it's called as international. Very simple. It may consist exporting of the business, licensing, opening sales office. Okay, exporting means you are producing the goods, you are selling it. Licensing means you are giving some services. Opening sales means you are buying some products from other company and you are selling it in some other country. Okay, so this international entrepreneurship is defined as development of international new ventures, development of international new businesses or startups that from their inception engage, means from the beginning itself, thus viewing their operation domain as international, means they are conducting their operations in international only from the starting of the process, Importance. What is its importance? International entrepreneurship is beneficial as the sales of a company are declining in domestic market. Means if you are producing some products that are less demand, that have been less demand in India, then obviously you are going to sell it in other countries. They can sell their products in international market considering demand for the product in other country. So if your product is very famous, you can sell it to other countries. Okay. Entrepreneur can sell their products in foreign market which have reached maturity stage of their life cycle in domestic product and earn profit by their sales. Means what? All the customers already got your product, then no more extra customers is available. Then you want to have more sales, then means obviously you are going for other countries. Companies which are incurring high level fixed cost can lower their manufacturing cost by spreading these fixed costs over a long number of units by selling their products in global market. Okay, I will explain. Now what is happening? You have a resources, but present government scenario, they are putting lot of tax on you. In some other country, the same process, the taxes from that government, other government is very, very less. Then obviously it will reduce your fixed cost. So taxation, the revenue, all those things, if they want to lower them, then you can go for international business. Okay. Entrepreneur can improve their entrepreneurial competitiveness and enhance reputation. Obviously, by going international, your reputation will be increased. Entrepreneur in the process of satisfying foreign customers have to produce product as their quality expectation, by which entrepreneur will not only produce quality product in international market but also in national market. Okay, if you are satisfying foreign customers, foreign customers demand or their quality requirement will be very, very high. They are expecting high quality products, so in that way you are increasing your quality, so that is also present for your national level products also. So in that way you are also growing and you are also getting the profit.